Hey everybody, and welcome back to some more Let's Play Scooby-Doo Night of 100 Frights. This is John Marston Joel. We're going to be firing up the third part of our series today. Get our load game started. We're already at 24%, it's hard to believe. Like I said, this game goes by fast in the last part, but it's a lot of fun at that. In the last episode, we collected the much-awaited helmet, much-needed at that, in the hedge maze. We explored the first few parts. We got our health back up to 5 dog tags, which was nice, and collected a brand new monster token. For those curious about the monster tokens, if we walk over to our left here, the monster gallery, we can activate the snack gate, take 150 snacks, and we can explore this brand new area. So concept art will be posted here much later on, and it's really neat. Explore here the picture gallery, and if we find a few of the monster tokens that we've collected, we can activate the villain animation and read more about some of the enemies in the game and from the cartoon series. So it's the gargoyle from A Good Medium is Rare. That was a part of the new Scooby-Doo movie series. Scooby and the gang joined a mysterious fortune teller for a seance. Trivia, after a little each monster token, who makes Scooby snacks? Honestly, I couldn't remember myself. Scooby Snack Factory. It's as simple as that, ladies and gentlemen. So we'll activate the gargoyle and won't spoil too many of the villains in the game, you can see here. Exit this area and we will proceed into Mystic Manor.
It's a warp gate!
It's a warp gate, Scoob. That's right. So we're back in Clamor, the Manor Part 1. This'll look familiar from the first part of my series.
Right.
Jump up through here. This is just me fooling around, seeing if I can get a few more snacks. Don't mind me. We're here to do a Let's Play, so let's keep going through here. This'll look familiar where we met Holly. She gave us the map. Collect the snack box now that we have the springs as well. The bats are getting better. There we go, get a nice chicken leg. And this little book sticking out here can be headbutted with a helmet. Creepy little music there. Ride the carpet up, get a sandwich. Same thing. Return through the bookcase, and we can proceed into the next area. A little interesting fact about this game. This is one of the more well-known games produced by THQ. They went out of business quite a few years back now. I mean, this is 2018. I think it has to have at least been 5 years. But, it's always kind of sad to see gaming publishers go broke, but that's the business. It's very competitive. And we've got two new enemies there. The Headless Spectre from the original cartoon series and the Creeper. Both within, like, funny enough, 2 episodes of each other, I believe. And go through the cobweb, as we saw earlier in the hedge maze. Collect some more snacks. Same thing goes for headbutting boxes. Take out another Headless Spectre clone. And with that, we've snuck through this cobweb here, which could have just gone straight. We can't go back through that door over right here, but we can keep going forward. And we can come back after to get the snack box at the top. Now we await Clamor in the Manor Part 3. Lots of snacks here, if my memory serves me right.
Run!
Werewolf. Pass through here, listen to his crazy sound effect voice. Grab snack box here.
Movie snacks.
Sounds a little tricky. Grab a nice piece of cake to restore our health. Avoid the flames. Avoid the Headless Spectre clone. Keep going through here. There we go. This one, these two you have to be a little careful with. Come back for those. Health is good. Nice little close-up of Scooby with the camera. Like I said, the camera varies throughout this whole Let's Play, so you'll see times I can't really control it, but... That's what it is. Yeah, the Spectre thinks he can take a swipe at me there and got him back. There's a couple of snacks here I missed. Scooby can swing on many chandeliers in the game, and they become kind of fun later on. Right now they're just hanging over a table, so there's not much to it. And with that, we're in Clamor in the Manor Part 4. In this room you have to be careful because Scooby slides on the wet parts of the floor. There's a key we're going to need to get to proceed. Let's see how we go about getting that. Keep following the snacks. Of course I have to veer off and grab these. There we go. And this tablet on the floor will help us get the key. So you gotta quickly run over. Jump up here. Grab the key. There you go. And you can also sneak through here.
It's a Headless Spectre!
This is another door. It serves as a portal, actually, almost like a warp gate, and it's locked from the other side. But we can sneak through this bookcase. Back to where we started, and proceed through this next little area. New enemy awaits us here. It's Geronimo. Decoy from a dog napper. Fifth episode of the original series. It's one thing I love about this series, I've talked about it before. This game, lots and lots of references to the original two cartoon series, both the new Scooby-Doo movies and of course, the original Scooby-Doo, where are you? Another warp gate. You can see where we've made it through so far. A little bit of progress. Can't head bonk these bookcases out, for that matter, unless they have a book sticking out, so we have to go back through here.
It's Geronimo!
Sneak through cobweb, take out Geronimo clone number two. One more cobweb, and another snack gate. 200 snacks, we were already up to 507. And a brand new area, Mind Your Manners, Part 1. We got some new enemies here, we got another witch now we can take out. This generator of wind will become much important later on. So for now, we'll just bypass this and avoid the, basic ghosts. I don't know if these really have a name to them from the original cartoon series. They're from the episode Hassle in the Castle. And they cannot be defeated, unlike the other enemies in the game. This one will only chase us so far. And with that, we'll sneak through here. Nice portrait of Redbeard. that might be foreshadowing later on in the game. Always try and grab as many snacks as I can coming through this area, because this area is a little bit tricky. There we go. Slide through here. There we go. Much appreciated. All the little things that Scooby can stand on. Go through here and activate the generator. That gets rid of the fog. And that wind turbine will become much useful later on in the game. Need a few more items for that to matter. Gotta trust your jump there. A little bit tricky. Grab that. One more chandelier and a new enemy. Well, it's another clone underneath. It is a werewolf. Sneak through here. And Mind Your Manners Part 2 is on the way. It's going to be a set of four keys to collect here.
It's the creeper! Whoa!
Lots of chaos in this part. I always love that little moment. Scooby sees the creeper and then Shaggy's being chased by one of those ghosts. I don't even remember if Shaggy pops up in this part. I think he's just gone.
Run!
And it's a slippery floor, so I see it got me there. Sneak through here, we got the four keys. Pop through this painting. Take out the head of Spectre clones again.
It's a headless Spectre!
Lots of snacks. Of course, for some reason, I can't get the snack box. I'll come back for it later. Take him out. Grab the box here. There we go. Got it that time. Very nice. Pop through here. Another painting. Another nice reference to Jekyll and Hyde, a guy who doesn't appear in the game, unfortunately, but I always liked looking at his painting, and I believe it pops up later in the game. It's moving, and they tease you, because with the creeper painting, it moves earlier in the game, and then he pops out, but unfortunately, maybe he was a cut enemy. I have no idea. Every game has cut content or deleted scenes as television, let's say. Store opens and closes. There's another monster token we can get here. We can just lower the chandeliers. And that is of Geronimo. As just discovered here. See if we can get this. Carefully swing here.
Oh, a monster token!
And of course, I have to fall. Quickly run through this area again. Be a lot of backtracking as you'll see through this game, but that's okay. A lot of Let's Plays all have that. The enemies do respawn in some circumstances, as you just see with the witches. Let's see if I can collect these other snacks here.
It's a headless Spectre!
Gotta just trust Scooby's jumps here.
Scooby! Yahoo!
There we go. I loved Scooby's voice in this game. All those little different sounds when you jump in the game. Swing from chandelier. There's one more bouncy bed there. And clap the snack box. And with that, folks, we are already in part 3 of this mini subsection. Cut through here. Door closes behind us. Lots of little snacks here to collect. Floating carpets to watch out for. They do help us get a few more. when we joined this area, we were up to 507 snacks, and we're already up to 460. So let's see how many we can get. Right, walk through here. Careful of the chandelier. Try and collect as many as you can. Swing back, right, left. You can jump down there if you want. Just one there. And now we gotta wait for the chandelier to come back, unfortunately. That's alright. You can try out near the slippers and lampshades I meant to try out in the hedge maze. Couldn't get the button controls to work. I thought maybe something was wrong with the old GameCube controller, but it's working just fine. Check that out. Sneak by enemies. It's sometimes useful. Grab those snacks. And with that, we can leave this part of the map. Proceed down here. Take out the werewolf. Try to get me there. And now we gotta quickly run through here.
Ruby snacks!
This door wouldn't open before, but now it does with the stepping on the tablet. Stone. Another warp gate. You can see how we've come from Clamor in the Manor. We'll keep going a little bit here in this part of the Let's Play. Exploring Mystic Manor. Got a new segment here, All Scares Upstairs. Save our progress. Quickly do a little run around here. Lots of snacks. This area used to be in the demo. If you waited on the loading screen, you'd get to see someone else play through this part. Little interesting piece of trivia there. Ooh, almost broke the game there and jumped off the bat. Watch for a split second there. Kind of interesting. Can swing around on the chandelier. Jump over here. Dodge the specter. Let's see if we can get some more snacks here. Watch out for the falling chandeliers. Take out the zombie. The chandelier to snag these. And with that, we got a new enemy right here. The Weaky Tiki from the original Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? And with the original sound, too.
It's a headless man.
Let him get me there. Wah. Yeah. Classic sound. Spectre gets his last laugh there. Sneak through here, grab a sandwich. Don't need, and some snacks. Before we get to part two, though, we're gonna head back the other way to see where that led us. And perhaps call it for there for another part of this Let's Play of Scooby-Doo Night of 100 Frights. Notice enemies haven't respawned here, like in other parts, except for the Spectre, but I didn't take them out the first time, so can't really count that. We can sneak back through here. Okay, do a single jump there. Grab the snack box, keep following the trail, and this will take us to a familiar part of the map. Here's Don Knotts. Hello, Scooby. Looks like you're going around in circles. This door takes you back to the first room in the mansion. I should just clean up these webs, but I think I'll just stand around here a while longer. And with that, now that the door was locked from the other side, Clamor in the Manor Part 1.
It's a headless specter!
And be prepared to be jumped by several headless specter clones. But we can keep going through here. Jump over here. Oh, and I missed the jump. It's okay. Joe knows some pretty good jumping tricks here to snag that. And two in one episode, that's pretty darn good. So with that, thank you for joining another episode of Scooby-Doo Night of 100 Frights. In the next episode, we will proceed more through Mystic Manor, see how far we can get, and we'll call things for another day. Have a great weekend, everybody. We're going to save our progress, see how far we're up to. We're at 28%. And Scooby hiding in his lampshades, quietly walking around. I've been John Marston Joe. You have been watching Scooby-Doo Night of 100 Frights. Thank you for joining in. Please give a like, comment, and subscribe for some more great country music and let's play uploads of some of my all-time favorite games. Got some Scooby-Doo, got some Super Mario games coming along the way, maybe some Paper Mario, and potentially some Red Dead and L.A. Noire. Until then, have a great weekend, everyone. Take care.